नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द असाइनमेंट इज The next question of the assignment has been displayed on your screen. See, the question is calculate inventory turnover ratio. We have to calculate inventory turnover ratio. Again, question based on the activity ratio. This is the one of the ratio of activity from the following information. What information has been given in the question? Opening inventory has been given. Purchase has been given. Revenue from operation, that is net sale, has been given. Gross profit is 30%. Gross profit is 30%. Now, beta, we know that inventory turnover ratio is equal to what? Cost of goods sold upon average inventory. Upon average inventory. Right. And to find the average inventory, we need to have we have the formula opening inventory plus closing inventory divided by 2. So, beta, neither we have close inventory nor we have COGS. So, first of all, we need to find these two values. Okay. Now, beta, first of all, what we will do? First of all, let's rectify this concept. Gross profit ratio is 30%. It means, beta, the profit is your, wo kitna hai? 30%. It means, beta, solution of 66th question of the assignment. According to the question, beta, gross profit ratio is equal to 30%. Agar beta kuch bhi given nahi hai, it means 30% of what? 30% of revenue from operation. Revenue from operation. Revenue from operation. If nothing has been specified in the question, it means gross profit is of what? Gross profit is of revenue from operation. Revenue from operation means net sales, which has been given in the question. So, beta, gross profit will be equal to 30/100 into 6 lakh. Gross profit is going to be equal to 30/100. Into 6 lakh, right? So, beta, when we solve this value, 00 00 will be cancel out, and what we will have? 6 3 18. 1 lakh 80. 1 lakh 80. Right. Now, beta, net sales has been given in the question. Gross profit has been given in the question. So, beta, COGS ka formula kya hoga? What will be the formula of COGS? Can I say that COGS will be equal to net sales? COGS will be equal to net sales minus gross profit. Net sales minus gross profit. And it will be equal to net sales has been given in the question, which is equal to 6 lakh. Minus gross profit is 1 lakh 80 thousand, so it is equal to 4 lakh 20 thousand. 4 lakh 20 thousand. So we have find the value of COG. Now we need to find the value of closing inventory. See, we also know that COGS is equal to opening inventory plus net purchase plus direct expenses minus closing inventory. Minus closing inventory. Right. According to the question, beta, not according to the question, we have just find the value of COGS, that is 4 lakh 20 thousand. 4 lakh 20 thousand. Opening inventory has been given in the question. You can see that the value of opening inventory is 50,000. The The value of opening inventory is 50. Net purchase also given in the question. That is 390,000. 390,000. Diet expenses hasn't given in the question. And now we can find the value of closing. So the closing inventory will be equal to will be equal to 390,000 plus 50,000. It will be equal to 440,000. It will be equal to 440,000 minus 420,000, and it will be equal to 20,000. So now, beta, we can find the value of average inventory. Now we can find the value of average inventory, which is equal to opening inventory plus closing inventory divided by 2. The value of opening inventory is 50,000. The closing inventory is 20,000 divided by 2. So it will be equal to 70,000 divided by 2, and it is equal to 35. Right. Now, inventory turnover ratio is equal to what? COGS upon average inventory. So, but what is the value of COGS? I think, 420,000. Value of COGS is 420,000. And value of average inventory we have just computed, that is 35,000. And when we calculate it, 3030 will be cancelled out. 75 to 35, 76 to 42, 5 and 5, 5 12 to 60. So but it is equal to 12 times. This is the answer of this. Okay.